This is a Rehau four-wire actuator, also called a wax motor. It has four wires. You put 24 volts AC across these two, and these are supposed to be an end switch. When this starts to get close to the open position or has reached the open position, it's supposed to close a set of contacts. The wax motor part of this worked. The end switch did not. I bought this from an outfit called Pex Outlet in Chicago on the internet. They don't seem to be very reputable, and they did not want to replace this defective unit. Be forewarned. So I'm going to take this apart and see what's going on with it. I used a screwdriver to forcibly pry this outside housing away from this lip. So I'm not sure if that's going to work again or not. In here is a pretty stiff spring. This is all pressed together. So when we apply 24 volts AC to this, the wax pot inside here gets hot and expands and pushes this up against that spring, which is also driving this up, which is releasing or opening a valve on the manifold on my radiant heat system. Now when it opens, it's supposed to make contact with what's called an end switch, and that tells your controller when it has actually opened and when a pump can start. When this is down all the way, this piece here is supposed to be pushing against that button on that micro switch. That button is not sticking out, so this switch is defective. But normally that would be sticking out, and as this wax pot heats up and expands, it would release that switch and close the set of contacts. A pretty sloppy job of soldering, and the heat shrink on here was melted. So I thought it'd be interesting to take this apart and have a look inside and see, first of all, why this isn't working, and if I could fix it, which I cannot because I do not have a switch like this. And we'll take this apart a little bit further and look at this wax pot mechanism. Like a lot of this stuff, it's not really meant to come apart. I just took a screwdriver and released these three catches. The wax motor lifts this and the spring returns it. So the top part here is pushing against the top of that finger, and the spring pressure pushes down on it. This is a symmetric piece. When you get things lined up, it fits that way, this way. So there's really no way to assemble this incorrectly. So that comes out, and then here we have the wax motor. And we can pull that out, and there's a spring-loaded contact that makes connection with this piece, and this ring connector makes contact with this copper piece up here, and that is the wax motor. So as that heats up, that expands and pushes up on this mechanism. I do not have a way of applying 24 volts AC to this, but I can apply 24 volts DC. So we'll power this up and see what happens to it. I unsoldered the switch. That wire is good. That wire is good. So there's no break in the wires. Put the tester on this micro switch. Nothing there and nothing there. And I've done the same thing by trying to activate this button. So that's dead. When this is cold, this is in here and this piece is flush. When it heats up, it sticks up about that much. So it's only coming up about 3 millimeters. So what I am going to do, I'm going to cut these green wires off. I'm going to cut them off here. I'm going to have to take this out to the vise in the shop, and I'm going to squeeze this back together and see if it will go back together. And then I will apply DC voltage to this, and we'll verify that it's still working. Okay, I tried half a dozen different ways to put this back together again, and it does not want to go back together. When I pried this thing apart, apparently these bits of plastic in here were damaged enough that it will not re-engage with this piece. I'm going to take this apart again, and we're going to show that little wax motor working under DC voltage. I have 24 volts DC applied to this. Now, as this heats up, this has been on for about 30 seconds. This gets to where it's too hot to touch. And when this is running, 24 volts AC is applied to this all the time that the valve is to remain open. So that could be for days at a time. This wax pot gets hot, and it will cause this plunger to extend, and you can see it's extending now. It will not retract on its own. That large spring that's in this assembly pushes it back together as it cools off. On the manifold, with that spring pressure against it, this takes about 10 minutes to cycle in one direction. And the total movement on this is about 3 millimeters. It's not a whole lot. With 24 volts DC, this is drawing about 1/10 of an amp. That has pretty much extended its full range. And we'll turn the power off. I soldered a wire onto the base of this. I couldn't get any solder to stick to this copper-colored thing, so I'm just using their spring connector. So when this cools off, then I can push it back together again. This has been cooling off for about a half an hour, and that big spring is not pushing against this, so it does not retract itself. But if I just push on that, it goes right back in again. If I heat it up, it'll come out again. Actually, this is capable of producing quite a bit of force.